Oh, to be a Hollywood actor. They get many of the things that the rest of us can only dream of. Fame, fortune, glory, stuff like that. But the job is harder than you might think. It takes dedication and a whole lot of preparation. Those who act in a series have virtually no free time. We did a little research in order to find out what it's like to be an actor on the set of an acclaimed television show. In this video, we're going to cover what exactly it costs to live this dream. So for all this and more, stay tuned here at Wonderlane. Very few are destined for the screen, and most of us are destined for the couch. You think you have what it takes? Be sure to let us know in the comments. Let's start with Two and a Half Men. The sitcom is one of the most successful comedy series ever, and it made its lead actors rich even by Hollywood standards. Production of the series was pretty smooth sailing until Charlie Sheen's dramatic exit. But even when things were good, the actors kind of lived under the studio's thumb. There was one rule about the appearance of Charlie and Alan. Since the creators wanted the brothers to have the same appearance throughout, both John Cryer and Charlie Sheen were not really allowed to change or alter their appearance. So they were stuck with the same hairstyle for years, and their weight had to stay pretty much the same. When John Cryer started balding, they started painting his hair on before shoots. By the time the series was drawing to a close, he was almost totally bald, and was rocking a waxy head of artificial hair on a regular basis. Nowadays, he rocks a shaved head with pride. Let's move on to the Big Bang Theory. This lovable bunch of nerds has been very popular for a while now, and even though the stars say that the shooting of the series was enjoyable, there were some rules and regulations that they had to follow. The filming of the show was unique in that it was filmed in front of a live studio audience. We don't see that much anymore these days. The audience reactions were recorded and added in under the show's audio, so the cast had to focus on giving a good on-screen performance as well as giving a good live performance. This often included little skits and dances to get the audience warmed up before a take. Leonard, Sheldon, and the gang had to eat a lot on set. There are many scenes in which characters can be seen eating, and it was common for the actors to end up eating several full meals on set. Kaylee Cuoco has said that when she read scripts and saw anything about food, she would give up breakfast and begin to mentally prepare. Several of the actors were vegan or vegetarian, so making the meat dishes look realistic was also quite a challenge. Let's move on to one of my all-time favorite shows, Breaking Bad. The series about the high school chemistry teacher turned drug lord is revered as one of the greatest shows of all time, largely due to its authentic characters who create an engaging story. The show is very much technically sound, and Walter White appears to be very knowledgeable, and this is no coincidence. The show's creators wanted the series to be realistic, and so they went to some tremendous lengths to make sure that it was. Bryan Cranston and Aaron Paul spent a significant amount of time with a chemist before production started, and they were actually taught step by step how to cook meth. But Cranston and Paul no longer remember how to cook, as it is an incredibly detailed and intricate process. Next, let's move on to the hit Netflix show Stranger Things. The sci-fi show, whose plot takes place in the 70s and 80s, has been one of the most successful series since the dawn of streaming services. Stranger Things is interesting because while the four lead actors are still children, the show casts a pretty wide net, and it's also aimed at adults. The directors put great emphasis on staying true to the time period, and this led to the incorporation of a pretty strange rule that pertains to the cast's physical appearance. In the 80s, it was much less common to see someone with washboard abs or a supermodel type figure, and the characters are also supposed to be average American kids and teens, so some actors were actually asked to put on a few pounds. Dacre Montgomery in particular was asked to kind of soften up, as he had just gotten into great shape for another role. Now let's move on to The Walking Dead. The show's creators put a great deal of importance on realistic action, which makes sense because so much of the show consists of fight scenes and running away from zombies. Each cast member received extensive combat training before the first shoot, but not just any combat training. They were taken to school by the Atlanta Police Department's SWAT unit. These training sessions provided the basis for all action sequences, and they served as a bit of a gut check for the cast. Let's head back over to Stranger Things and take a look at a rule placed on the actors to prevent spoilers. The producers of the show have gone to some tremendous lengths to keep the content of future episodes from being leaked. Spoilers could lead to a drastic decrease in viewership, and so the cast can face severe penalties if they violate certain rules. Netflix micromanages their social media accounts, and they aren't allowed to post on set or in costume. There are also certain things that they can and cannot say in interviews. And there's another series that kind of declared war on spoilers, and that's Game of Thrones. The 8th and final season has already been released, but Game of Thrones pretty much one-up Stranger Things when it comes to spoiler prevention. Actors would be flown out to set, sometimes in remote locations, regardless of whether or not they were actually in the scene. Having everyone on set gave the creators the opportunity to subtly manufacture fake spoilers, thus altering audience expectations. HBO went as far as to shoot different versions of the same scene. This way the cast couldn't spoil the show even if they wanted to, because they didn't really know what was going on. Table reads were always approached with extreme caution. Once the cast had the chance to read through the script together, all copies except for two were shredded right there in the room. The two copies were kept in a very secure location, and the actors only had access to the script digitally on set. Last but not least, we come to a series that has not been filmed for 7 years, but it's still known and loved by many. Desperate Housewives. Even though the actors achieved worldwide fame through the show and were able to make a ton of money, some details about the production of the show have come to light that reveal what life was really like for the cast while the show was running. To prevent spoilers, the actors didn't get access to the scripts until the night before shooting, but the script still had to be memorized in its entirety. Many cast members have come out and said that the stress caused by this measure made it a pretty miserable experience. So that's going to do it for this video on some of the restrictions that rest on the shoulders of some of the brightest stars on television. Which one of these restrictions stands out most to you? Be sure to let us know in the comments. And as always, if you enjoyed the video, be sure to hit that like button and subscribe to Wonderlane for new videos like this every week.